Hey guys, and welcome to another You Should Be Watching video. This time we're talking about a movie by Ridley Scott. Ridley Scott is an amazing movie director, and generally when you ask people about their favorite Ridley Scott movie, many will say Alien or Blade Runner. Those two seem most typical choices for a favorite Ridley Scott movie, and a lot will say Gladiator 2, yeah. And all really good movies. Great movies, actually, but I don't think any of them quite match the amazingness and epicness of the one I'm going to talk about here, and that's Kingdom of Heaven. Kingdom of Heaven is one of my favorite movies of all time. Literally, it's my favorite Ridley Scott movie and one of my favorite movies of all time. I already talked about this movie when I did my top 10 best medieval movies of all time, but this time I'm going to talk about the movie much more in depth. I love medieval times, and Kingdom of Heaven is literally the best medieval movie ever and one of my favorite movies ever. I love medieval times. It's literally one of my favorite historical periods to read and learn about. I love medieval times. Kingdom of Heaven is not only the greatest medieval movie of all time, but it's literally one of the greatest movies ever made. And I'm specifically talking about the director's cut version. When I first watched the movie, like in 2005, I didn't really like it that much. I was a little kid and I didn't understand much. Later, when I was older and I watched the theatrical version, I liked it a lot more, actually. I loved it then. But then, once I saw the director's cut version, I realized that the theatrical version is nothing compared to the director's cut. So yeah, stick with the director's cut. That's the definite version of the movie, that's the masterpiece version, and the one that truly captures Ridley Scott's vision and glory. The first thing I will talk about is the music. The music and the score are simply excellent. And I love how much it captures the feeling of the medieval times. Like the very beginning overture that takes like 4 minutes is perfect introduction and already sets up a feeling of an incredible journey that we are about to experience in this great movie. Just listen to the beginning of it. See, this music very much captures the tone of the medieval movie we are about to watch. Whenever I watch that movie, I truly feel like I'm transported back to medieval times. The movie truly captures the medieval atmosphere. The story is amazing. It's about a young blacksmith, Balian of Ibelin, whose wife died, and the priest provoked Balian with taunting him that his wife is in hell because she was suicide, and Balian angrily murdered the priest. So Balian decided to travel to Jerusalem, where he believes he can serve God and redeem himself and obtain salvation. In Jerusalem, Balian's faith gets tested, and Balian learns so much more about religion, as well as what it truly means to be a good knight, and if crusades really were a moral decision. In general, he noticed sometimes that being a good person doesn't mean listening to the religious authorities. In fact, sometimes the opposite might actually be true, because the religious authorities might be the ones that actually want to obtain power in the name of religion. I will also talk about another story in the movie, and that is about King Baldwin and his sister Sibylla. King Baldwin is sick with leprosy and he doesn't have many days to live. Still, he's a very good king who believes in peace in Jerusalem between Christians and Muslims. And because he constantly wears silver mask,
He almost feels like a ghost, which is pretty consistent with the idea that he's going to die soon. And what's also tragic in that story is that after he finally does die, his sister Sibylla discovers that her own son has leprosy, just like his uncle. And based on that, she has to make a very tough decision. I love themes in this movie in general. I love how the movie discusses things like religion, faith, as well as extremism, and that there can be extremism in all religions. I'm also very interested in religion in general. I'm a Roman Catholic myself, and I love how the movie deeply dives into the Catholic faith, but also talks a lot about the Muslim faith too, and it talks how people of different religions can actually live in peace with each other if they just learn to accept the differences. Ultimately, the message of the movie can be described as religion and faith are not bad. What is bad is when people use religion as a way to obtain power and divide. This message is very true today as it was back then. I also love how the movie doesn't go on a black and white route. Instead of making crusaders as heroes and Saracens as villains, the movie decides to show us that there are hateful fanatics on both sides. On the crusader side, we have a fanatical nobleman Reynald de Chatillon and Guy de Lusignan, who was actually pretty cruel in real life, both of them. While on the Saracen side, we have an unnamed advisor of Salah ad-Din, who's standing right next to him here actually. And I love that. It is much closer to history and how it was in real life. It's not religion that is bad. It's the individual humans in all religions. And the dialogue in this movie is also amazing. Like, one great example of an amazing conversation between two people is when King Baldwin first appears and his conversation with Balian of Ibelin. That dialogue between the two men shows what type of king King Baldwin is, and also how much he's suffering because he's sick with leprosy. Like, this scene really goes into a detail about leprosy. King Baldwin claims that Saracens believe it's a punishment from God, and then he says that if hell is really worse than what he's going through now, then he basically calls it unfair. And that really drives the point home how much he is suffering. And all the interactions between Balian and the Hospitaller are simply incredible. And literally some of my favorite interactions in the entire movie. Like, we never know the actual name of the Hospitaller. Like, and that makes him even more interesting. And there has been a theory among fans that he's actually an angel on Earth. And I like that theory a lot. I really buy it. And the interactions between him and Balian very much imply it might actually be the case. Like, for example, the way he talks about difference between religion and faith in God, and how he says that people have been using religion to achieve power. And he does not actually believe in the war between Christians and Muslims. He thinks people of all religions should live in peace with each other. And just listen to that amazing quote from him.
I put no stock in religion. By the word religion, I've seen the lunacy of fanatics of every denomination be called the will of God. I've seen too much religion in the eyes of too many murderers. Holiness is in right action and courage on behalf of those who cannot defend themselves. And goodness. What God desires is here and here. And what you decide to do every day, you will be a good man. Or not.
Every single interaction between Balian and the Hospitaller is simply magnificent and amazing. And those conversations are probably most important in the entire movie and very much drive the themes of the movie home. I will also give a shout out to the last scene in the movie where King Richard the Lionheart makes a cameo. That's a wicked cool scene at the end of an already very fantastic movie. The performances are great too. Lots of people complain how Orlando Bloom shouldn't play Balian of Ibelin, but personally, I always disagreed. I thought he did a really great job in the role he was given. And Liam Neeson as his father Godfrey is just phenomenal. And I also really loved Brendan Gleeson as hateful to Reynald de Chatillon. And Eva Green is also pretty good as Sibylla. And let's also talk about the battle scenes. Battle scenes in this movie are pretty excellent. They are gritty, realistic and pretty spectacular. And they very much put Braveheart battles to shame. And Braveheart had also some very good battles.
Overall, Kingdom of Heaven is not just the greatest medieval movie ever made and not just the best Ridley Scott movie ever made. It's one of the best movies ever made in filmmaking history, in my opinion. And I'm talking, as I said, about the director's cut version. This movie truly deserves a lot more recognition and a lot more love. I really wish a lot of more of you guys would watch that masterpiece of filmmaking. Okay guys, so here I talked about Kingdom of Heaven. Did you see this awesome movie? What did you think about it? Press the like button, please subscribe to this channel, and I will talk to you soon in a regular movie review. Talk to you soon, bye!